Hey everyone, welcome back to NDC. Today we're tackling a small but essential step in building your app, adding an app icon to your Xcode project. Whether you're designing from scratch or using AI tools to generate ideas, this tutorial will cover resizing your icon, formatting it for Xcode, and any tips for creating a standout design. Let's go ahead and get started. So let's say you already have your app icon design and you want to get that thing into Xcode. So what you need to do is open up your project. So in this case, I have my coin flip dice ruler, and you'll want to click on assets. Under assets, you should be able to select the app icon. This should be, you know, pre-made with any iOS templates that you have. And you should be able to drag and drop your selected icon into Xcode directly. You'll notice that we do have a yellow caution sign symbol here, saying that it's actually too small, although it is a perfect square at 420 by 420, and unfortunately does not match the 1024 by 1024 that's required. So the easiest way to do this is to open up the image on your Mac. So for me, anytime I open up an image, it's with preview. If yours doesn't open with preview by default, you can right-click, choose preview. Once you have your image open, you should be able to kind of press these extra arrows here and open up markup. Sometimes those arrows are already there. From here, you can select on the adjust size option. So it kind of looks like some rectangles within squares. Go ahead and click on that. We can actually choose the fit into, and we can change this to be 1024 by 1024. Now, because my image is a perfect square, this is already fine. If yours isn't a perfect square, you might need to uncheck this scale proportionally, right? If you have numbers here that aren't 1024, 1024, unchecking this, it might kind of warp your image just a little bit, but it will allow it to resize it to the perfect square. Once we're done, we can hit OK. We have our new image. We have to zoom out here because it was pretty small before. Let's go ahead and now drag and drop this into Xcode, and we can see that little caution sign is absolutely gone. Now, when we run our app, when we go to the home page, we can see, so this was the coin flip. I already have some other apps with some app icons here, but our coin flip dice roller has our app icon. There's also the option for dark and tinted as well. So if you don't have preview or you've been having trouble resizing it with preview, I'm going to put all the links in the description below in case you need to access them. You can use this website here, makeappicon.com. You can either select the file here or drag and drop it onto the toaster. So I'm going to have this copy that's still the 420 size. Oh, look, I basically got toasted. My little Memoji of me got put in the toaster. But this is a great website because it actually provides you with all the icons and sizes you could ever need. Even if you wanted to do Android, you have the availability there. Then you can press the download icons. This is a free to use tool, and they have this little cute kitten with who looks like Puss in Boots, maybe from Shrek. Please help me by sharing on Twitter. So if you want to give them a shout out for, you know, the tools, feel free to do so. I'm making the video, so that's my version of the shout out, right? So we get a zip folder here, so I'm just going to go ahead and uncompress that. We can open that up. We have Android, iMessenger, we'll want the iOS ones, and we can see that we have the app icons here with all the different sizes we could ever want, which is absolutely great. Let's see, so if we were to change this to be list style, we can see that we have literally everything we could ever want within here. So shout out to Make App Icon. There's also appicon.co, which apparently has an AI generator, I'm not sure. But we can go ahead and upload our copy here. So we'll drag it on over here. We'll hit generate. Get a lot of downloads. Get another zip file. My desktop's gonna be so messy for this example here. We can open that up and we have everything we need. And it even has the Play Store, App Store, right? And it has the icon sets here too as well. So any size that you could ever want. Again, you'll want that 1024 for Xcode. So you go ahead and add that to your project. And this should be, yep, A-OK. If you don't currently have an app icon and you're curious where to start, I would check out websites like Canva, If you're interested in AI, maybe you can use a DALL-E, a Bing image creator, right? Have fun with those. There's also this website here, logo.com, where you can enter a name and a little bit about your project here. You can see some of the examples here, but essentially you can go through the steps, entering the name and creating it from scratch. Of course, always feel free to design your own logo, you know, if you have skills in Illustrator, Photoshop, things like that. You know, I like to use AI for inspiration, but I'd prefer to make something. I'm by no means a graphic designer, but I find that to be pretty enjoyable. If you don't have access to tools like Adobe Illustrator or Photoshop or things like that, I'd actually recommend Canva for a free online tool. So what you can do is you press the Create a Design button, and you can actually just search for app icon, and it should say iOS icon here, 1024 by 1024, which is perfect for Xcode. And from here, you have your little, like, I guess, canvas that you can play around on. So you can use the elements. I'm by no means a master of Canva. You might want to, like, just Google Canva tutorial. It's pretty easy to use, though. So we can have things like coin, right? Some coin. We can grab some here. Right? Don't judge my graphic design skills, please. We can add text, right? Coin flipper, we can change the font up here, right? Change the size. You can add like gradients, right? You can definitely make a cooler app design logo than I can. One thing with Canva, it is also layered. So, you know, you can layer things on top or in front of one another. Your app icon, again, it's gonna look way cooler than mine, but Canva's a free to use tool that you can use. Once you have a design that you like, you can hit the share button and then download, which should download it as a PNG. And you should be good to go to add it to your Xcode project. One other thing to consider is on Xcode, if you click on the app icons here, you can actually right click on the screen here and we can do add new assets and then iOS add app icon if you don't find it here. If you have a messages extension icon, things like that, it might be blocked by my camera, but hopefully you can also see if you want to add tvOS app icon and top shelf images. So let's go ahead and add the tvOS one here. And we can see that we have the tvOS, and then you can kind of have this brands asset here, which if you remember from our download from makeappicon.com, we can click on OBS and we have all of the different availabilities here as well. So you can find the appropriate size and it should fit into your Xcode project. So if you're curious on, you know, if you're making like a watchOS app and things like this, you can right click, let's say watchOS, new watchOS app icon, right? For the most part, they should all be 1024, but some things like the iPhone Retina might be a little bit smaller of a size. So I just wanted to bring that to your attention. Before we wrap up, I want to go quickly over some tips for designing a great app icon. First and foremost, keep it simple. Why app icons are small and any overly complex design might be cluttered or unrecognizable. You probably can't see, but on this weather report app example that I created, it actually has weather report across the kind of app icon there, and it's really small text, so it's hard to see. Focus on a single concept or recognizable element of your app. It's also a good idea to use contrasting colors to make that kind of text or anything that you want pop, right? I would use tools like coolers.co to create a bold color palette. Make sure you design for small sizes. Remember they're small. Test your icon by kind of scaling it down. If you're like creating it in Illustrator, kind of zoom out, or even pop it on Xcode and see how it looks in real time with the simulator. Make sure you align with the platform guidelines. So Apple actually has strict requirements for app icons, including size and shape. You can refer to Apple's human interface guidelines for app icons to ensure compliance. I'll also pop the link in that in the description. There's gonna be a lot of links down there today. Make it memorable, right? When we think of powerful brands, you know, like you could drive down the street and see the golden arches for McDonald's, right? That's recognizable. Also make sure that you test it for light and dark mode so it looks good on different home screen wallpapers. You can also use gradients or subtle shadows. So a lot of modern icons use gradients and shadows for a sleek, professional look. I absolutely love a gradient moment. So I think in like almost all the apps I work on, when I do the backgrounds, I have like a gradient. I don't know, I love it. Shadows also are cool because they make things pop. But that's it. Adding an app icon is one of the small details that makes your app feel polished and professional. Whether you design from scratch, use AI, or rely on branding tools, the process is straightforward once you know how. If you found this helpful, please like and subscribe. Feel free to share your favorite app icon tip in the comments below. I hope you have fun with it. My examples here on the iPhone are pretty bad, but you know, just remember, have fun, stick to your brand, and dream big. And code bigger, even though we didn't do any coding today. Still, this is a very important part of mobile app development. And 1024 by 1024 in preview. Don't forget. And if you do, that's the Xcode. Anyways, take care.